Well, how do, ladies and gentlemen and boys and girls? I'm Drew Hutcheson, and science is my business, and our very special business today is the Periodic Table of the Elements. Now, if you want to be an amazing musician, you need to learn the notes. And if you want to be an amazing scientist, you need to learn the atoms. A scientist who can't tell the alkali metals from the halogens is like a musician who can't tell a C major chord from an F minor. Now, luckily, after watching this video, you'll be able to name the 10 groups of elements, point out the metals, metalloids, and nonmetals, and recognize a pattern in the size of the atoms called the periodic trend for atomic radius. Now, how do I remember all of this? Well, I made up a fake story that connects to the real information. I call this the periodic fable. Imagine a tall metal tower standing in a faraway land called Little Earth. The tower is the home of an evil wizard named Al. His last name is Cal, and Al Cal watches the peoples of Little Earth from a fiery eye at the top of his metal tower. Next to Al Cal Eye Tower, he has built the Al Cal Mine for Earth's metals. Al's evil minions work day and night in the mine, gathering metals to build an army of evil robots. The largest of Al's robots is Francine the Feared, and she guards the entrance at the bottom of Al-Kali Tower day and night. Al dreams of using his robot army to conquer and rule all the free peoples of Little Earth, but for now, Transition Trench separates him from them. What's that you say? Who are the free peoples of Little Earth? Well, I'm glad you asked. The group closest to the trench is the Barons. The Barons are the Builders. The next tower is the Cardinal's Hospital. The Cardinals are the priests and healers of the free peoples. The Knights live next to the Cardinals. The Knights are the peacekeepers and the military. The Oxmen live in the fourth tower. They are gifted farmers and chefs, and they can pull their own plows through their fields. The next tower is home to a group of magic users. The Halo Gens cast a protective halo around all the towers of the free peoples to keep them safe from any magical attacks Al Cal might try from across the trench. Now, the sixth and highest tower is home to the nobles, leaders of the free peoples, and the head of the nobles is a kind and wise fairy wizard named Healy for his amazing healing abilities. Years ago, the Barons built a great stairway. Healy could often be seen visiting the people along the stair steps as he made his way to check on Al-Kal's activities at the top of the Barons' tower. One day, Healy used magical vision to look into Al's mine through the cliffside. Al's minions were busy building another tower. Oh wait, that's a bridge! Once the bridge was completed, Al could lift it out of the mine and use it to transition across the trench, attacking the free peoples with his minions and robots. Seeing this coming danger, Healy and the other nobles asked the Barons to build a secret bridge called the Inner Transition Bridge and carve a doorway into the mine. Under the cover of darkness, the Knights sneak into the chamber and plant a hidden bomb inside Al's bridge. The next morning, as Al lifts the bridge, the bomb comes with it and explodes, defeating Al once and for all. And there was much rejoicing. Can you connect the towers and groups of the periodic fable with the columns and groups of the periodic table? Reading from left to right, we start with the alkali metals, then the alkaline earth metals, then the transition metals, then the inner transition metals. Now we have four groups named for the element at the top: the boron group, the carbon group, the nitrogen group, the oxygen group. Finish it off with the halogens and the noble gases. Those are the groups. What do they mean? Elements in the same group have similar physical and chemical properties. Francine and Healy, the largest and smallest members of Little Earth, were created to remind us of francium and helium, the largest and smallest elements of the real world. Elements closer to the lower left of the table are larger in size. This is called the periodic trend of atomic radius. If you imagine an atom being shaped like a ball, the radius of the ball is a good way to measure its size. The stairs in the fable represent a stair-step line in the periodic table. This line separates the metals on the left from the nonmetals on the right, and the elements who sit on each stair step are called metalloids because they sometimes act like metals and sometimes act like nonmetals. There are seven metalloids. But with only 5 stair steps, where are the other 2 metalloids? They live under the stairs. These elements are germanium, abbreviated GE, and antimony, abbreviated SB. To remember these 2 elements, I imagine a German ant who lives under the stairs on the periodic table. Well, hopefully that'll help you remember some things about the periodic table of the elements. To review, you should be able to name the 10 groups of elements. Use this stair-step line to point out the metals, metalloids, and nonmetals, and recognize a pattern in the size of the atoms called the periodic trend for atomic radius. Let's do a couple practice questions to test our knowledge. Number 1, which element will have a larger atomic radius, lithium, Li, or beryllium, Be? Well, lithium is larger because it is closer to the lower left by being to the left of beryllium. Number 2, carbon, element C, versus silicon, Si. Who has the larger atomic radius? Silicon will be larger because it is lower than carbon. Number 3, can you classify these 4 elements as metals, nonmetals, or metalloids? Lithium and beryllium are metals because they are left of the stair step line. Silicon is a metalloid, it sits on the stairs, and carbon is a nonmetal. Number 4, can you name the groups each element belongs to? Lithium is an alkali metal, beryllium is an alkaline earth metal, and carbon and silicon are both members of the carbon group. Number 5, which 2 elements will have similar properties? Carbon and silicon are in the same group, so they will have similar properties. Please comment below if you have any questions about the groups of the periodic table. Also, create and share your own examples about the element groups or atomic radius for others to answer in the comment thread. Thanks for watching, and may the mass times acceleration be with you always.